Instead, you get me or got someone Ibemere. The editor in chief of Ripples Media.
Ripples Nigeria.
Thank you for correcting me on top of this matter. First of all, congratulations.
Thank you very much.
Because we're very, not you know, easy.
You know, this is at all.
At all. Out of 329, shoe, 35 countries.
You know, this is at
person
all.
Person go wonder, say, wait till you know the writer and that person never writes. Because it means they will not set on herself apart from the matter.
That's not true.
Before we go enter this particular, you know, matter, and this, you know, Echo underscore 9 platform, we carry on our commons and everything. Maybe we talk about even online journalism as a whole for Nigeria.
Okay.
As I talk on my intro, say, when we first start online journalism, that whole issue about what's in Gudu paper, we see everybody don't already they used to, and we still they sell papers. So even those newspapers can't even transition, enter online. So in case you don't want to buy, you fit subscribe to the online. But how the journey don't they? So far,
okay, you know, say where the world did today, nobody died there for 1900. The world don't evolve, you know, those early days, we know they for digital space. Those days now, more like cut and nail, you know, like they call them traditional newspaper that time. You know, we never evolved to where you know we did now. And waiting cause all these things, you know, now the coming of the internet,
yes,
you know, with internet. It's easier to, you know, to read papers, you know, online. So where are we today for journalism in terms of the digital age is because of the evolution of technology itself. So as mankind, they progress, now so every aspect of life and industry, they also progress. And newspapers, they left out. So for those who practice practice journalism in the early days, 70s and 80s, they were more into, you know, traditional newspaper, print, you know, that one, you go press, you go print time, to distribute time, you go either move and by road or transport and by air and all that. And that one make them today do one or two editions.
If you say online journalism go ever phase out print, you know, traditional print papers?
You know, say, as human being, a person don't fit see too much into the future, okay? But as a day, I think two of them will complement each other. Mm. Where are we there now? They call it media convergence. So you have both print and the digital, you know, playing side by side.
Yes.
It will take a long time because where are we there now? The young people themselves, you know, they won't do anything with print. But the older ones, you know, our parents and grandparents, they still in love with their old, you know, traditional newspaper, the print edition. So it will take some time, but the stage where we're there now, me, I see some complementarity, you know, between print and digital publication.
I say make I ask because as the way the world they go, like my neighbor go tell me say children will be saying good, then they born now. So many of them no go ever feel whole barrel for their hand. Now computer, then they go take the rights. We will graduate from pencil to biro, say the way the world they go now, once and just bond them to even write their name, not to type them
out. It's looking like that. Almost everything we do today, you know, it's about the computer. You know, even going to space, just if you look around the environment, because you say the world don't progress a lot, you know, and that is what technology brings, you know, to the space.
So
it go take
because
time.
Because some mass communication students when we did school, you get course when we say we do that time. Shout out to Dr. Salau if you look me so. When we say we learn squeegee and all those different parts of printing press, I'm not like give you that course. It be like say my trial that time because hey, and we still get online journalism one side though, but what not on this kind of front. So we the one that say as time they go hope say curriculums too for university go also they evolve. To reflect, you know, our economy and our society today.
We don't get choice on the matter.
Honestly speaking.
If we just stay one place, we go just. If you don't innovate, you go just die. That's just the truth. If you don't innovate, you go die. And the rest of the world will just leave you behind. The time where some of us have been practicing journalism, you know, you have to go to the press, from letter press to web of printing and all that. You need to understand how people go through machine, they fold them, they wrap them, do all those things. But not anymore. Nowadays, for a digital age, it's basically computer based. So, you go print, you go distribute through social media, Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, LinkedIn, and the rest of them. So instead of using motor, instead of using aeroplane, you go begin use social media to distribute your news.
I mean, talking about online journalism, maybe we'll talk about people they go to school, go study this, because some people say just stumble upon them, you know, anyhow. And I mean, I want to just to emphasize, you know, this same matter. Say what you don't talk about, they're very, very important. The need to evolve, even for the lecturers, because most of these lecturers, when we say, still they teach mass communication. True. Some of them not even there for university, so they're not even there updated. True. So they don't even know how to use social media. Absolutely to true. Pass across message. So students, the time we say you're supposed to spend to develop yourself today, you know, current, you go take and still they learn parts of machine because it did there. I will not say our university curriculum still there as it did from decades ago. They never sure. change. So we talk about this online journalism and take on to the next level. I beg universities. Universities go. They're very important. You know, to seek your lecturers and find out how current they
we
are.
We don't just get choice for the matter.
Well, I hope otherwise, so.
Otherwise, we go just there for the backwaters.
We see the beg since they made them change curriculum. We never change. And we see the way we did. Anyway, once again, a big congratulations on this win.
Thank
but
we
could just
much.
Know more about this, your Eco_9 platform, plus okay. platform rather. What's in the thing there about?
Okay, as Abi said, the world, they face a global challenge, especially in the area of environment.
Yes.
And reporting the environment is still a big problem for most Nigerians.
Underreported, sir.
Yes, underreported. Yes. And even for those with the report, the skills, the tools, you know, to take, you know, report effectively, you know, they too are available.
True.
So what will be proposed to do under the Google News Initiative Innovation Challenge, now to set up, you know, a platform, mm-hmm. both web, you know, and an app, you know, we go gather data, analyze them, visualize them, and then make them available, you know, to every person where they are there, so that it could be easy for people to interact with the environment, noting they happen, and be able to predict, you know, our environment. So we believe that as we do that, it will help us, you know, contain, you know, the adverse effects of global warming and the general, you know, challenges with the environment they face. So it's more like one go-to place,
yes.
you know, for any person we want, you know, get information regarding the environment, whether there's desertification, erosion, and the rest of them, especially for journalists, so that they will fit report the environment better. And we believe, say, that if we do them, you know, very well for Nigeria, we fit take the same idea, you know, to the rest of Africa, and our continent will do better for
us. I agree with you. First, one thing very important, I'm saying you mentioned in an issue of gathering data.
Yeah.
Data are the new oil.
Absolutely.
And when it comes to the issue of environment for Nigeria, they're very scarce.
True.
If NIMET not give us what we say then get,
we know even nothing they happen.
At all, and you manage just scavenge small paper to know, and those reports are inside paper, and then they put them.
True.
People feel easily
true.
Skip them.
True.
I remember one time, a person be report about some kind of seismic shift. Maybe Nigeria be experienced
yes,
at one point.
I think somewhere
in,
the southwest.
Exactly.
Also.
Mm. We never hear anything about the matter again.
It just shows say we know to get data.
If
and even when we get, we don't even know nothing to take and do.
God, you don't you talk know. And flesh and
so
blood did not reveal
it's,
this.
It's important. That's why this project we want to bring to the space will create a lot of awareness
yes.
to let people understand that if you really want to play in today's world and even in the future, you need information, you need data. But it's not just raw data. You should be able to analyze it and know what it will take data do.
But wait, so this is an initiative we will propose, right?
Yes.
Okay.
In fact, it's going to be the first of its kind. It's historic for Ripples Nigeria.
So my point now be say you mentioned something very important. Say even the tools required
yes.
to make them reality also they
yes.
lacking.
Yes.
By virtue of UNAD getting recognition for this initiative.
Yes.
What will come with this recognition? It go feel provide UNAD the tools we say UNAD need to report on the environment. I've been adjust. You know, to create the awareness and look for the experts who will make them possible.
No,
how this
it,
what
it, it,
be
it is more than awareness.
All right,
you know,
talk about
just
that.
Like you've been in note, you know, at the beginning of,
yes.
the, of the program, this is about innovation.
Yes.
Okay. We don't pretend say we get all the expertise. Once you they relate with the with a big platform like Google,
mm-hmm.
I mean, you can imagine the expertise we could there at your disposal. So Google, they actively involved 100%, you know, for this project.
Yes.
You know, so now our idea, but mm-hmm. they go sponsor and they go stand with us, you know, to develop the ideas we don't get. And so those things have to do with the right skill, you know, and the right tool to be able to, you know, investigate, interrogate, you know, our environment. So it's not just about creating awareness. No, it's much more than that.
Clearly.
To gather data itself now work. To sit down, analyze them, now work. You need tools.
So,
you need
Google
the skills.
So Google now go provide the tools that someone need.
Absolutely.
Then I won't get very clear from that matter. And I talk say, of course, it did beyond just letting people know.
Yes.
Yeah, in different ways, you don't already answer this question. But the fact say, you know, beyond just your daily reporting, make it be say we don't put content out there.
Yes.
You be sit down, analyze your own environment, analyze your beats, then come up with something from the matter. But just tell us how you feel say this thing will change the face of journalism.
It will change the face of journalism because if you look around us, you go see every person just they play in the same space.
Exactly.
You get to know what they call differentiation. Mm-hmm. From beginning, Ripples Nigeria, we just set ourselves apart and say, no, we're not going to do what every person they do.
True.
We're going to set ourselves apart and do something that is special. So we chose the environment. You know, it's a new area. They call them geo-journalism, you know. And we are the first to concentrate energy for that area. So we not just want to do what every person they did. We chose to play in the data journalism space. So even as we talk about the environment, it has to do with data where it could benefit us in terms of how we use the information to manage our environment. Mm. So it's something completely different, is you know, from what every person they do. Yes, we report every other thing, politics, you know, policy and the economy and all that. But we just say, no, as Nigeria they concerned,
yes,
we just see that gap in the area of reporting the environment. Or what is now within the world that they now call geojournalism. Mm-hmm. And we just tapped into it. And that's why for us, this is a historic moment for the Nigerian press.
All right.
And we believe every person will benefit from it. Once we do them, and we do them very well, it will help our colleagues within the industry to see what they happen and then carry on with
all right.
it.
So in conclusion, yes, and in a nutshell,
yes,
what do you feel, say, in Nigeria, the problem with Nigerian media right now, and which solution you would prefer, just in a nutshell?
One.
Yes.
Skills. We know to get people this skilled, you know, in the industry.
What do you think is responsible for that?
Education. You know, when you talk initially, you been say something about education and all that.
Yes.
Not many people will go through school. Now, I'm sorry to say, I don't want to call any person name.
Yeah.
We go through school, if you come out, fits writes one sentence correctly. So skill is lacking. And we believe that those of us we God don't bless, we don't go through the industry a bit, that we need to give back. And one way to give back is to help them sharpen their skills,
yes.
is to also mentor them so that they will fit, do within some of us, we don't the experience, you know, they do. So skills gap is a major issue.
I agree with you.
And then the tools to work with it.
Mm-hmm.
And that's why a lot of our colleagues, they run away from contemporary journalism.
Yes.
When you talk about data, when you talk about geojournalism, most of them, they run away from it because they know they're skilled enough. And that's why even for Ripples Nigeria, we set up a center called Ripples Center for Data and Investigative Journalism.
Mm.
Special unit. And that's how we decided to carve out that space for ourselves. Now, very few, you know, online platforms. And in fact, general media in the country, we carve out that kind of small space. For us, we didn't know, but there's so much, you know, that we're bringing to the space because we don't see those gaps. And we believe that if we don't play the role that we are playing now, it go hard for the younger ones where they, you know, we won't play in the media space. We won't, you know, take journalism as profession.
Well, I hope media owners, you know, they listen to you and they're not going to carry that Nigerian attitude of to say when these ones first come, now we've already been there here before them. Because we find out that most media houses, honestly speaking, do not invest.
They don't.
They don't invest in their, you know, in their talents.
Sometimes when they invest, they go, this is not for machine. Meanwhile, they're supposed to invest for
now,
people.
Now, wait, I won't talk. Renovation to bring in new machine. But the thing we say, as they give your office facelift,
the
talents were there because they're not already comfortable with the norm.
Not true.
You know, they're not there comfortable with waiting them being savvy before. So to the regurgitate waiting they're already there. No, because they talk and begin say, because even the people who say they run the business, you go ask yourself, say, how much of journalism do you understand? Most of them are businessmen. They're not the journalists to begin with.
True.
How much of them they understand? Even they themselves, they don't even upgrade to begin with, talk more. So when
that's a very serious question. Because if you don't know it in day,
you not fit.
How you go take add value to the industry day inside? And like you said, most of them just won't take build influence for
as
themselves.
As long as advance
very,
will come in.
Exactly, very few.
Yeah.
Even nowadays, where the advance they come like that, there are several opportunities.
Of course,
if nobody say we shine our eyes, it's waiting the happen for outside. How we go take no say Google itself get opportunities, you know, for Nigerian journalists.
No, honestly.
And that's why we call on other journalists to say, look. Beyond just sitting down to the editorials, there are a lot of opportunities out there. If you explore your environment, you go see opportunities there. Beyond Nigeria, where you go fit, learn more, equip yourself, get better skills, and then return greater value to the industry.
I really appreciate this interview because I remember a person be asking me the same question for interview. I mean, I was on the other side off the table, you know. And the person asked me, say, what's the problem with our media today? And I say, well, most media houses, and they were saying they call magnanimous with mediocrity. It's the truth. We're very comfortable with it. So when you come out and you want to sound professional, you be like, now you be the devil when carry come. Because they be like, wait, what do you want to tell us? You get him. Why do you want to pass yourself? Exactly. And issue with it. But congratulations once
Thank
again.
Thank you very much.
On this, I'm looking forward, honestly speaking, to waiting your platform go bring into this particular space. Because the discussions on the environment, they happen globally.
Seriously.
And we did see what happened
last week. Maybe everywhere, here. Flash flood and all that. We don't even know where they come from.
No, we believe our own.
If to say we know thing, they were supposed to know, say something like that go.
I said, when I see Germany own, that's at home I saw.
Exactly.
I said, in case when I talk, saying I got away in the block for a year, how far?
Exactly.
You know, nature itself, you know, they tell us something and we need to hear and make adjustments. Thank you so much.
You do.
Now, I've got Samuel Ibemere, and I don't talk to him, the editor in chief. Ripples
Nigeria
Media. Now, India here with us. Give us your social media handle. Maybe people, I know some people they wonder, say, I beg, I want this training, me say for upgrade. Where they feel reaching?
Yeah, Ripples Nigeria for Facebook.
Okay.
Same thing for, of course, everybody knows say Twitter, don't they done now. Ripples Nigeria to, you know, NG.
Yes.
For Instagram.
Okay.
And we also there on LinkedIn.
All right.
Once you just search for Ripples Nigeria, all those social media handles will just
show.
You know, just show. You know, get wahala. Our community around Facebook is almost massive, very, very massive. Over 500,000 people on Facebook, they follow us on Facebook.
Okay.
So, and that's the only way to go. If you don't get motor or get a plane to take, distribute your content, the social media handles there, and that's where the world is.
It's true.
You know, our people need to understand these things and take full advantage of them.
So people, when they wonder, say, you want to enter journalism, when I don't hear them now, not just can't enter, can't they do the old or the same of the same? See where to follow to upgrade yourself. No, say yourself can be game changer for this our media worker.